Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back. Today is February 27th, Tuesday. Anyway, February 27th, 2018, it's Tuesday. I'm on the road, I'm taking you guys with me today. Hope you enjoy the ride. By the way, I didn't really think I was gonna get that much awesome reception yesterday for mentioning Amanda B. I guess I'm not the only fan out there. But anywho, I wasn't trying to be any, you know, like a weird guy or anything like that. Just, you know, just kind of stating the facts, you know. But anywho, yeah, let's just go moving on. Today, I'm actually going to, you know, I'm taking you guys with me because I'm on the road, like I was just saying, and I'm going to be filming a friend of mine. She has to do some work, and so I'm just out there, you know, just helping her, just a little B-roll, helping her out film just a little something for her, unrelated. So I'm going to do kind of like my on-the-road daily vlog and, you know, just bring you guys with me, and I'll chat while I'm there through the day and, you know, whatever. We'll have a little fun with this today. But... you know, let's talk cryptocurrency real quick. Seems like it's, you know, pretty fucking good. Everything's holding steady so far. Yeah, nothing really much to talk about. So I'm sure I'll bring something up at some point. Anywho, buy it while it's still cheap, okay? Yeah, there's some really cool... oh, yeah, I was watching something about this thing called the flattening. Because, you know, obviously Bitcoin Cash is crap and Litecoin is awesome. I'm going to see if I can find the website and put a link down there so you can get an idea of what, you know, what I'm talking about. You might have already seen it. I think it was something that was mentioned in the world of Bitcoin news or some shit like that. But, yeah, just start buying that Litecoin because, look, worst case scenario is going to be worth $1,000. So that's a times five, you know. Increase. All right, guys. Well, I'll see you guys later, okay? It's because I got to start driving and heading over there, all right? I have a long day of a lot of things to do, so, yeah. All right. Hope you guys enjoy the day. By the way, it's fucking freezing out here. It's cloudy. It was raining. It's almost March. I'm in L.A. What the hell's going on here? I thought it was supposed to be warm. Anyway. All right, guys. So much for global warming, right? Maybe Clip 5 was right, huh? Maybe we're all going to freeze over before you know it. Maybe it's going to start snowing here any day now. Oh, shit. No, just kidding. All right. Hey guys, all right, so I'm in here in the studio, right? The Neon studio. And we're setting up a little setup here. We got the GoPro going. We're gonna do some time lapse. And so we're just setting up the, kind of like the background. So we can, you know, some, what is it? Some props we're setting up, right? So they can look pretty.
No, don't put any of that in.
So we're working on that.
Like, we're set up a time lapse. Just gonna paint on this. It's for Coachella. That's it.
That's it? So that's all you want me to say?
No,
that we're doing
no,
a time lapse?
The subsidiary bullshit does not matter. It's what are we doing? Not that.
By the way, I'm getting vlogging lessons from her, okay? But maybe she's right. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
I don't know about your prop background setup.
No, okay. They just want to see. What do they want to know?
What are you doing?
They just want to know that I'm here to film you doing a time lapse. That's it.
You're hilarious, man.
I want some coffee. Hey,
over here, look, over here we got something on the ground. It's important. Look, right here. Oh, look. Here, there's another thing. Interesting, right? I know, life, it's crazy.
You know, there are people who walk around and say, hey, look, a dog turd, you know? You know, dog turds are interesting, you know, especially if you don't step on them. See, I'm like the horriblest vlogger.
Dog turds, don't step on them or do, depending on, you know, how you want your day to go. It's up to you.
So, yeah, this is my typical day, guys, all right? So, all right, so let's start spray painting shit, right?
Yeah.
Legally. Yeah, so in this studio, it's like a glass blowing studio. As you can see, look at all the glass materials behind me. Now, on the other side, that way, is where like actual, you know, all the finished projects are, but I can't show them to you because they're hush hush, top secret. So, yeah, it's pretty cool to be in here. You know, it's amazing art. She's an amazing artist. It's an amazing studio. They have an amazing glass blowers in here. Super fucking cool. But yeah, look at all that. Isn't that pretty cool? Look at that shit. And there's that prop situation.
Go buy some freaking shit.
Yeah? We gotta go to the store?
Yeah.
Let's go to the
what
store.
What time is it?
12:36. Alright, so we're gonna go to the store. We're gonna go pick stuff up. Go pick up a table, right? Mm-hmm. That's Bertha again. If you guys know who Bertha is. You guys remember Bertha? That's my ex-wife. Remember
Finishes.
Bertha?
No.
It's okay. You can talk about Bertha. It's okay.
I don't know what you're talking about, man. Let's go.
Hi, sir. Hi, cuties.
Hey.
She likes Jose.
Yeah, you want to say hi to everybody.
That's cute.
All right, so we're going to Hollywood, right? Not North Hollywood, not West Hollywood, but Hollywood. That's the only place, right? Apparently, her art supplies are because she's very specific.
Hollywood be the greatest witnesses on the stand.
Look how important she is.
So, really, what we laid out in the.
I'll see you at the art store. Fancy.
What are these?
You guys can help me know, okay?
I'm gonna need to grab some aerosol.
Sure.
What are these? You mix it in with like a
oil paint.
Can you just paint with the stick?
You could draw with it, or you can, yeah, you can chop a piece off and blend it like you would, or like mix it down like you would with any oil paint.
And if you just draw with it, is it kind of like drawn with like? Kind of,
pretty soft. They're softer too. R&F sticks are even softer, like lipstick.
Oh really?
But these ones are a little harder. But it's softer than, it's kind of, I guess like the texture might be kind of like a streak if you've done that. If you used a solid marker. But it's different. It's higher quality. It's oil paint.
Damn. Those look fun.
Yeah, they're
okay,
cool.
Let's see what you got here. Wow.
On the Montana,
let's do a neon yellow and a neon pink.
You know, the bingo markers, and that's exactly the color there. Matte satin varnish, and then they have transparent white and transparent black.
Which of all the varnishes, like a protective coat, which brand do you think is the best? This is gonna be like, I'm working on something, obviously I know these fade over time, it's gonna be out in the sun at Coachella. So I wanna put like a protective coating on after the fact to try to preserve it a little bit better. What do you recommend?
I think golden makes the best one. I'll show you. We have the Krylon behind you, but I like this over here.
Go to series two, that'd be $6. So then you can get blue. See, the blues are $6. Crimson medium or light.
One is a small. Yeah. Like smaller pieces and stuff. Beautiful. Yeah, the main finish is just like wash, super opaque and flat, except it.
How much are these?
Six something, I think. Yeah, $6.50.
Do it,
see you, dude. I see where you come all the way.
Well, they just have like the best supply, the best stuff.
It's like a kid in a candy store.
Bye.
Hey guys, look, it's raining in LA. Yeah, we're here to getting tables. This table?
Yeah.
Extension cords and all that shit. So, all right, I'm gonna put this out. It's fucking wet out here. Hey guys, well, I hope you enjoyed today's adventure, hanging out with, you know, my friend, as we, you know, ran around town getting supplies, got stuck in the rain. It's already nice and, you know, clear out again. But yeah, like, I stopped filming because it was raining when we got back to the studio and we had to run a bunch of stuff in and, you know, I don't want to get the camera all wet and that whole deal. So, anyway, and then, yeah, that's it. I was already finished with her, and then I started running a few errands, and I was like, oh, let me finish, you know, let me film a quick ending. So this is the quick ending. If I think of any cryptocurrency stuff before I upload this, I'll record something and put it in there somewhere in the middle because, you know, that's why you guys watch me, right? I'm sure a lot of things have been going on today. I just haven't even looked at the news or even Zero Hedge or YouTube or anything today. I have been off the grid, if you want to call it that. So actually I got a few minutes coming up right now. This is where I'm filming, so I'm gonna take a little smoke break, and as I take my smoke break, I'll look at the news and see all that stuff, and maybe after I take my smoke break, I'll film a little something about what I learned. All right guys, hey, if not, thanks again for watching. Please like, please subscribe, and I'll see you guys mañana. All right. Hey guys, well, I'm home. I know I did an ending. I think I did an ending. Not sure if I did. I just, long day and got a lot of things in my head. But anyway, this is a second ending, if that's that's even a thing. I listened to some of, you know, what was going on today, crypto world, and it seems to be the only thing really eventful going on was that the monetary policy and state of the economy. Anyway, the Congress, yeah, hold on. So anyway, Congress met today in order to talk to the head of the Fed. I was just trying to give you the formal, yeah, the monetary policy and the state of the economy talk. But anyway, it seems, you know, I heard, you know, Gregory Mannarino talking about this, and he was pretty much saying how, yeah, the Fed pretty much lied to Congress. So the Fed said, hey, everything is fine, hunky-dory. But, you know, as you know, I don't put the links in the bottom. A link straight to the Fed website that will show you that, no, everything is not hunky-dory. So, anyway, with that being said, yeah, that about sums it up for today. That'll be the end of the episode, okay? So thanks again for watching, guys. Please like, please subscribe. And I'll see you guys mañana, all right? Someday. Some people get excited for that, like camels. Oh yeah, sorry, last thing. I seem to have cut myself off when I was talking about that. But anyway, with the whole Fed talking to Congress and telling them that everything is fine, again, all this is signals. These are all signals. It's all signaling, you know, meaning all systems go towards 100K Bitcoin. Why? They're pretty much saying, hey, everything's fine. Don't look over here, look over there. So with that being said, you know, that's all that happened today. Sure, it was a momentous day in history. Sure, it was a crime committed against the American public today as the head of the Fed, you know, lied straight through his teeth to Congress, which again is a crime punishable. I don't know if it's through death, you know, I just wanted to say that. But but it is definitely a crime to lie to Congress. And that happened today. And, you know, but again, it's not even news anymore, right? It's just, it's not even anything. It's not a school shooting or anything like that, right? So anyway, yeah, guys, hope you like the art. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Last time, for real, promise, no more.